Hey there, my name is Carl and I'm the creator of Don't Flip a Ninja. As you can see, I am an incredible martial artist. Not. So I need your help to defeat these ninjas. Let's take a look at the parts. I need a lot of help to defeat the ninjas. Hey everybody, thank you for coming to this components overview from Don't Flip a Ninja. What you see here is everything that comes in the box. It's all the components for the game. I'm going to take a look at them one at a time and tell you what they're about. What you see here are the player aids and the matches reference cards. The player aids include a step-by-step setup with an illustration, a components breakdown, the uses for your katanas, and the turn sequence. These are handy when you first play the game a few times, but after a while you should be able to play with these set aside. These two cards are identical. These are the matches reference cards. There's two of them just to make it easy so multiple players can be looking at them during the game. On these cards are the various matches you might make while playing the game. You'll flip two cards over on your turn, and then you can refer to this card to see if the two cards you flipped make a match. If they did, you just follow the instructions. What we have here are the prison mat and the ninja path. The prison mat is where you'll put ninjas when you capture them. You win the game by getting four ninjas on there. The ninja path is where the ninja pawn moves. It's slowly going to creep its way toward the castle, and that's your objective, is to prevent it from getting to the castle. The ninja mat is two-sided. The side with 10 spaces makes the game a little bit easier. It's just one of a couple of ways to set the difficulty in the game. These are your handy-dandy katanas. Every player will start play with one. They come in four different colors, but that's only for player preference. The color doesn't make a difference. On the back of each katana card is a quick reference for how to use it in play. They can do things like retreat the ninja on the ninja path if it gets too close to the castle. You can remove ninjas from play when they're in the discard pile. And you can even prevent wounds. So the katana is a one-use item that players can use during the game to help slow down the encroachment of the ninjas. And this is your life. Well, at least it's your life cards. You'll begin play with four of them, and as you take wounds during the game, you flip them over to the wound side. But don't worry, if you find the game too challenging, the game also comes with an extra life. So you can start the game with five life instead. This is the main deck of the game. There's just about 50 cards in the deck. You've got samurais and ninjas, you've got shuriken and nobori. These are cards that are going to help you win. These are cards that are going to try to do you harm. This, of course, is the ever-vigilant ninja pawn, keeping an eye on things. The cards have a variety of images on them. They're all UV-coated, which helps with the wear and tear and helps prevent smudges and whatnot. The cards are durable but flexible. They're very bend-resistant and made with a full black core, so they're completely opaque. Everything in the game is made of the same material except for the ninja pawn, which is made of pure evil. I mean, it's made of wood. And that is the component overview for Don't Flip a Ninja. Thanks for being here. If you have any questions about the game, please go into the video comments and let me know. Thanks again for being here. Have a good one.